Hello everybody, today I will give you a very small introduction to cryptography. So what is cryptography? Cryptography is the science of using mathematics to encrypt and decrypt data. That means there is two terms here. One is encrypt, another is decrypt. So what is this encrypt? It is converting your message into some form which is unrecognizable or not readable for any illegitimate user or unauthenticated user. And decrypt data or decryption is if there is a legal user or legitimate user, then with valid key, he should be able to decrypt the data and convert the unrecognized form to readable form. Okay, so it involves two things: encrypt and decrypt the data. So cryptography enables you to store sensitive information and transmit it across insecure network. So what network we are using, called as internet, is treated as insecure network, so that it cannot be read by anyone except the intended recipient. That means when you're sending it, you know, anybody can capture the data, but he can capture, but he or she should not be able to read it or understand it, what is there inside it. Only to whom the data is intended or you are sending, he must be able to read it. Now, what is cryptography? In short, it is the art of secret writing, the art of protection using information, and science of encrypting or hiding secrets. It is needed for confidentiality. So, as you know that there is a three cryptographic requirements given by CIA. C for confidentiality, I for integrity, and A for authorization or authenticity. Okay, so these three are the basic cryptographic primitive we targeting for, and these cryptographic techniques are the, you know, the encryption and decryption are used or satisfy the first one, that is confidentiality. Now, of security is not a security. You have to understand that all security should reside in the keys. That means algorithm and cipher and everything can be unknown to all, or people can know what, you know, or capture it, what you are using. But the key should not be, you know, revealed by anybody, and the whole security of the encryption should be residing to the key. That means if you lose the key or you disclose the key, your information is going to be disclosed. Otherwise, if you're not going to disclose the key, nobody should able to read your information. This secret algorithm should hide secret bugs or secret troubles. So that is the reason we don't have secret algorithm. Cryptographic algorithms are always open, and anybody can take it, and most of the algorithm not algorithms are open, but for using it, there may be copyright and other issues, patent issues, but algorithms are open, and big reason is that, you must know what that algorithm is doing actually for you, and there is not any trapdoor or somebody is not writing any bug inside the algorithm. Okay, then keyless algorithms does not exist. So many people claims that keyless encryption, but actually it does not exist. There is indirectly or passively there is some key always involved in encryption. Then claims that something has not been broken are meaningless but hard to refute or disprove. That means if somebody comes with something, some algorithm, cryptographic algorithm, and says that this is not breakable, that is meaningless. Nobody can assure a final word that this particular algorithm is not breakable. Okay, today it is not breakable. Maybe somebody else will break it after some day. Okay. So, yeah, here is the general concept of cryptography, what I am speaking about, you know, from the beginning. So Alice is communicating with Bob and he wants to send some message to Bob. Now, what Alice will do? Alice will encrypt the message with some key, secret key. And now message is encrypted and that encrypted message is going to deliver to Bob. Now, Bob can decrypt and read this message by using the same key. Okay, if this is the situation, we will say that it is a symmetric key encryption because both the end receiver and sender are using same key. Now, if you look at this, here is some taxonomy or different classification of cryptography. So, it starts with cryptology. Cryptology can be divided into two different domain or subdomain. You can say cryptography and cryptanalysis. What is cryptography? Cryptography basically involves two types of cryptography. One is private key cryptography or secret key. Another is public key cryptography. Okay. So again, private key cryptographies are of two types: block cipher and string cipher. And on the other hand, public key cryptography, basically can be done using two kind of method. One is called integer factorization. Another is called discrete logarithm problem. Okay. So, and cryptanalysis is totally another domain. That what encryption algorithm you are developing here, how to break that, or how to reveal the message without having proper knowledge of key. Okay, so that is what is cryptanalysis. Now here is a formal definition for encryption, how it looks like. So we have plain text, we have a function E which does the encryption. Okay. So when it pass the plain text M to E, it gives us the ciphertext C. Okay. This is the concept of encryption. And in the same way here, the concept of decryption. For decryption, what happens? The receiver who received the ciphertext, he have the ciphertext C, he have the function D which can decrypt the message C and give you M, the plain text. Okay. And cryptanalysis is here, when the ciphertext you are transmitting and there is somebody who is having a black box, does some attack, try different things on the ciphertext, without having proper knowledge of the original key. If this method of study of revealing the plain text without knowing key by attacking it, okay, by breaking the cipher, is called as cryptanalysis. Now here you can see the modification of the concept of encryption. What I had told you that cipher is generated by encryption algorithm E by taking M, but it should mention that it takes two things as input. The encryption algorithm, one is the plain text, another is the key K. Okay, so basically three parts are there for an encryption system or crypto system. First one is the algorithm called key generation part. Okay, the algorithm must be probabilistic and randomized, and it should generate a key. The output is key given by K. And encryption algorithm, which takes input key K and plain text message M. Okay, and it generates the ciphertext C. Okay, and there is another part of the crypto system that is called decryption algorithm, which takes input the key K and ciphertext C and generate the original message by decrypting the ciphertext using the key. Okay, so the overall system can be summarized like this formally. Encrypto system like this for all K, okay, for all message M in the domain, must be a decryption algorithm which can take the input which is generated by the encryption algorithm, that is EK given M. Okay, so this will generate C. So C is the cipher. Okay, so that will take and generate the original message M. Okay, so the whole thing, the last, this slide and this slide, I know, can be summarized with this one in single line. Now, here is the different attacks on encrypted messages. First one is ciphertext only attack. That means the attacker knows the algorithm definitely, and he have collected a set of ciphertext and trying to analyze all those ciphertext and finding out what can be the key or how to get reveal the message, original message in the ciphertext. Another kind of attack can happen that is called known plain text. That means plain text is known, algorithm is known, and the cipher, the ciphertext can be decided or to be decoded is known. Okay, that means here the attacker is having three things. He is having the knowledge of algorithm, what algorithm we are using. He is having a set of ciphertext which to be decoded, and as well as their corresponding plain text. Okay, so this mapping kind of thing he can establish here. That is for this plain text, maybe this is the ciphertext. Next, if this is the mapping plain text to ciphertext, then what is the secret key behind it, which is using this algorithm giving me this ciphertext. Okay, so that he can guess the key from doing this analysis. Then chosen plain text. Here the attacker is having encryption algorithm, ciphertext to be decoded. Now plain text and a ciphertext pair he is having, and that is chosen by the crypto analyst or attacker. Okay, that which pairs of plain text and ciphertext will be analyzed by him. That is chosen by him. Okay, the attacker or cryptanalyst. Okay, then chosen ciphertext. Here the algorithm is known to him. Ciphertext to be decoded is also known to him, and purported ciphertext chosen by the cryptanalyst. So here it was the cryptanalyst was choosing this set of plain text. Here is using the set of ciphertext. Okay, and then is chosen text, that is analyst, cryptanalyst is having the algorithm, having set of ciphertext to be decoded, and he is choosing a set of plain text and set of ciphertext, which he thinks that this this selected set will help me to break the cipher easily. Okay. Then so here is another thing, brute force. That means if we are speaking about key, so it is totally depend on how strong key you have. If you look at this, this is a lock which is locked by your key of this lock is a combination of four digits, right? And these four digits can be starting from 0000 to 9999. But if you look at this lock very carefully, you will understand that the maximum number of keys are possible is 4 times 9s. Okay, so if you don't know what is the key to open this lock, you have to try for 4 times 9s, 9999 times. Okay, and definitely you will be succeed out of them one time. Okay, so here is the calculation. If you have four symbols and your key is a combination of three out of these four, then the total number is going to be 4 to the power 3 equal to 64. Here it is 4 to the power 4 will be there for this lock. Okay, so here is the average time required for doing a exhaustive key search or brute force. If you have 32-bit key, it will take for a modern computer 2.15 milliseconds. If you have 56-bit key, it will take 10 hours. If you have 128-bit key, it will take 5.4 into 10 to the power 18 years, and remaining I am not saying. Okay, you can read it. This is huge time. Now, defense against brute force attack is increase the key length, okay, increase password complexity, limit login attempt, so that people should not able to attempt up to a certain time. You can see that online banking system and many other secure website will not allow you to attempt, you know, more than 3 times or maximum 5 times. Okay, after that it will lock your system, your login credentials, and you have to just recover your new password again. Okay, then use captcha so that, you know, automated multiple try should not be done by machine or bot. So using captcha you can just make sure that the login or that access is done by some human being. Okay, then multiple factor authentication, that means you may have multiple authentication way like a mobile SMS, then email code plus password, so 3-4 thing you can combine together and you can have a multi-factor authentication. Okay, this is here is simplest but most widely used concept of encryption. You can see this is a truth table of JOR function or XOR function, exclusive OR function, right? So M you can treat as a message, key you can treat, and K you can treat as key, and the result of JORing these two can be treated as C. So if you have this, you know, this truth table of JOR function, as you all know, and now if you look at this example, M equal to this 1100 1100, and the key you have is 1001001. Now if you do, you know, JOR among these bitwise, then you will get C equal to 01011111. Okay, now you can do one thing, you can do JOR between K and C together. Say you don't know M, or I have not given you M, I have given you K, I have given you C. Okay, now you can JOR these two together and you will get the magic, you know, the message M back. Okay, so that is the interesting thing about JOR, which is we call as inversible function. Okay, and another two things related to cryptography is randomized and deterministic encryption. Randomized means it is quite, saying random in computer science domain is very much, I can say far from that, reality, because most of the desktops are, our system what we use are deterministic. So it is very hard to develop a totally randomized encryption system. And deterministic encryption system means you are using some PRNG or some pseudo random number generator. That means the whatever key and whatever random numbers are used in the encryption technique, they are deterministic. Basically their process of generation are deterministic, and yes, your whole system is deterministic. So most of the encryption algorithms are using deterministic technique. Okay, so thank you for watching. Please subscribe this channel, you will get more videos like this.